ICC World 2020 from 2010, obviously a great moment for you in your career. Talk to me a bit about what the build-up was like and what the atmosphere was like in the group at that time.
Yeah, it was actually a strange build-up. We played against the Lions out here in the UAE at Abu Dhabi, and Keyswetter and Lummi smashed us all over the place. And I remember myself and Andy Flower were kind of looking at each other saying, is this the type of player we need in? We agreed it was the type of player that we needed in, and to take a bit of a risk, take a bit of an approach that we'd never done in the past. Always felt, and Andy always felt, that we were quite conservative when it came to World Cups and in our approach. And we thought, you know, nothing's worked in the past, why not take a really kind of a bold approach? And the World Cup's only 3 weeks long. We just said, look, this 3 weeks is going to be all about confidence, the mental side. And coming from the IPL, I realised that a lot of the drills that these guys were doing, with range hitting or bowlers doing skill work and hitting cones and stuff like that, was all to do with the confidence. And I thought it was a crucial factor that once we got over there, that's all we focused on. And when we had time off, enjoy yourselves. And you know, when you're enjoying things, you seem to play much better or train much better as well. And every game came along, the confidence just grew all the time. So it was, you know, looking back, it was one of those things that just clicked. Everybody clicked at the same time, and I thought the bowlers throughout the tournament were just second to none. You know, we had Yards and Swanee in the middle of the order there, who were doing fantastic jobs. The bowlers, in fact, it went 9 games, the bowlers, without going over 147 runs. You're going to win a lot of games when you do that. You don't need many batsmen in the side if you're not knocking off more than 147.
What were the key moments in the run-up to the final? What were the points in the games that you look back on and think they were key moments to winning those matches?
Good question. I don't think we ever thought we were going to lose. I mean, that's a strange thing. But I just knew we were that well drilled and confident that we had a great, great chance. And I guess the key moment was when I was walking out with the team to sing the national anthems. We held the hands of a lot of children, obviously leading them out to the middle. And I asked what the young girl's name was. She went, Lucky. And I thought, you know, we were going to win this. That moment, I thought, I like that kind of thing.
What was that final like against Australia? Tell me about that.
You know, if you're going to win a World Cup final, you want to beat Australia in the World Cup final. They were the next best team. We knew we were coming up against a great side. They had a lot of pace on the side. But I also knew that even though they had pace, we could utilise that pace. You know, 2020 cricket, if you get half a bat on it, you're going to hit it to the boundary. So I was hoping that was going to work in our favour. Eventually it did. And, you know, to win and beat Australia in the World Cup final in Barbados as well, it doesn't really get much better than that, because it's obviously a fantastic place to party afterwards.
To hit the winning one as well, is that a career highlight? Is it up there?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. I mean, it's just I can't actually explain what the heart was doing when, you know, when Shane Watson was running into ball, and just that thought of, please, just get bat on ball. I don't know, I don't care what it looks like. I just want to get one run and get to the other end, and the relief of once I ran through and hit the ball and ran through, and kind of, you don't know what to do, you just like let yourself go and start running, and everybody was running out their dugout, and it was fantastic times. I mean, I look at the smiling now, it's obviously hairs on the back of the neck stuff, so it's great memories.